Turn your Bibles to Ephesians chapter 6, and while we're doing that, I'd like to thank Pastor for giving me this opportunity to preach for a couple minutes. And so, Ephesians chapter 6 and verse number 10 says, "Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, and against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, to stand. Stand therefore, having your loins girt about with truth, and having on the breastplate of righteousness, your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith ye shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked, and take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God, praying always with all prayer and supplication in all spirit, and watching thereunto with all perseverance and supplication for all saints." So I would like to turn your attention to verse number 13. "Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all to stand." The evil day has come, and we are now wrestling with the rulers of the darkness of this world. And in verse 11, we're dealing with the wiles of the devil. And there's only one way we can overcome these things, and that is by putting on the whole armor of God, and so that we may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all to stand. Can we say that we've done all to stand now? You might ask, how would I know if I've done all to stand? Well, the Bible tells us that in verses 14 to 17. Verse 14 says, "Stand therefore, having your loins girt about with truth." So number one is to speak the truth. And verse 14 keeps going. And having on the breastplate of righteousness. We need to do right, what is right in the eyes of God. And verse 15 says, "And your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace." So we need to ask God for peace and try to make peace in our lives. And verse 16, "Above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith ye shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked." So number four, put your faith in God. Verse 17, "And take the helmet of salvation." We need to trust God as a personal Savior. And, verse 17 keeps going and says, "And take the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God." We need to study the Word of God and hide it in our hearts. And now we can't do any of this without asking God for help. John 15, at the end of verse 5 says, "For without me, ye can do nothing." Amen. And so why are we putting on the whole armor of God? So that we can withstand in the evil day, having done all to stand.